I'm not sure. I think
you've got a game face on it.
Who taught you to fair play?
Okay. Ring the bell, Sam.
Okay, what word did Miss Spencer exclaim when she was exasperated with the students?
I don't know. I was never in her class. No, she didn't.
Just hands up. Sam, breathe!
They got it already.
Come on, ball.
This one. Okay, who was the foreign language teacher in the new high school?
This is Ben Wayne.
Yes. Whoa, John! Yay! What was the name of the school newspaper?
Oh,
come on. Good for you!
Penny
Pellis. Yay!
Wow. I feel hugged for that.
What was the name of the high school band director?
Is it Mr. Wright?
Yes! Oh, Mr. Wright. Remember, there are people who will have their hands raised. Hey, Larry, do you still know how to run?
Yes.
Okay, that's all you need. Okay, can you name the musical we presented senior year? Apparently not.
What? Gidget? Was it that year?
Gidget what?
Gidget Goes Hawaii.
Yay! Yeah!
John knows the answer to this.
What grade were we in when the hula hoop was so popular? Somebody said sixth over there. I heard it.
But I was going to say sixth.
You were going to say, okay, you won. It was sixth grade. Owned by Wally Ludke.
Yeah.
What seasonal item did he sell at his place of business?
Seasonal.
I don't know. Christmas tree. All I want to say.
Christmas tree.
Christmas tree. Oh! I should tell you. Junior High had a unique structural feature. What was it?
Crack on the upside.
Yay! Yeah. Just south of the park where our library stands now. What was the name of the store and what did they sell?
Our store.
Right here.
That was across the alley east of Sarah's grocery store.
Right here, Charlie.
Ring the bell.
You're cheating.
Okay. This question actually came from somebody, not me, but I think they were right. Who was our leading basketball scorer?
John Powell.
Ken Batson. But John was great. There's lots of them who are going to know the answer. Okay. But I don't think you're going to know because I didn't know. This is another one that came from somebody else.
Okay.
Who drove the school bus to out-of-town sports events?
Oh, come on. Okay, guys.
Lucky Skelly.
Over here.
Frank Soden.
Frank Soden.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Kastonian. Good luck.
Here we go.
Oh,
shake hands. Okay. Who was the cook who would give seconds to athletes during hot lunch?
Oh.
I think that.
Yeah. Oh, all right.
Yes, it's
Spear. Mrs. Spear.
Yay! He was my first dance partner in fifth grade.
Aww. Lewis's dance partner in Tokyo. Yeah, I had to do that. Okay, what was Richard Sorensen's middle initial?
We're going to do it. Team effort.
Yeah, there you go.
Sure we are.
Coming out. Okay, name one of the two pharmacies in downtown Marion when we were in high school.
Okay.
Stores.
Yes.
Did
you know the answer? You have to know the answer before you deem the deaner.
Sounds like Russ Hipple.
Okay, ready?
Yes.
What motion picture won the Academy Awards in 1965, the year we graduated?
Oh, where's your teacher? Who's got your teacher?
Well, somebody got me over here.
That's not fair. No. Mike, you go home now.
I don't know if I know the answer.
Okay, ready?
Yes.
In 1965, what Righteous Brothers song was a number one hit?
Oh, for Christ's sake. I don't know.
You know that one? Raise your hand if you know it.
I got a guess. I have to go to the honor.
You have to go get it.
Oh, first. Right.
I'm going to defer to my friend, Rosie Dipple.
He said, Endless Love.
No.
Who
was the assistant wrestling coach?
Yeah.
You better know that.
2 years older.
Mrs. Linda.
Yay!
Yeah.
All right.
That was Joe.
Yeah.
Larry.
Okay,
and Linda.
Name two distinctive items that have been in the city park since we were small children.
Statue and the popcorn stand.
Okay, I'm going to take it. It's not actually there anymore, but that's okay. I'll take it because it was there when we were kids.
That's exactly right.
Yes. Can you name two more?
What was the question again?
Two distinctive items that were in the city park since we were children. I have been singing these my entire life, so these are not just abstractly taken off the internet with me thinking you might not know them.
Yeah, right.
I'm hoping you know them. And there's one person in here who definitely does know the answers because I played all of these for him, so watch for Bob's hand if you don't know these. And he's right up front by the deer.
And I knew them without you telling me.
Yeah, he knew them without me telling him.
I hope so.
Okay.
Just one of them?
Let me pick two people.
Yeah, you can have it.
But I may not put my hand up. I'm not here.
Oh boy, okay. John Fowler.
You can do it.
Are you singing? Okay. Oh no, I'm not singing.
Oh.
No.
Oh, sing them.
I had a horrible time trying to figure out how to get these on a CD. And I was trying to think of a live tape player to record it with a microphone, and that didn't work because for some reason it only recorded from either a CD to a tape or a tape to a CD, so that tape recorder didn't work. And then I thought, you idiot, you have a digital piano. I took the microphone for the digital piano, held it up to the speaker on the computer, then went into my creative recorder. I quickly pushed the recorder button and then quickly went back up, and I got it all recorded right in with the same computer through my digital piano, so I'm so proud of myself. Wow. Okay, I was afraid he was looking at the answers, and he said he can't see, so it doesn't matter. Here's our first one, and boy, is it hard, guys. Okay, here we go. Get ready with the dinger.
They have to name it, right?
The name of the TV show.
It's a TV theme song.
Oh, okay.
Well, listen. TV show. Listen carefully. This goes way, way back, guys.
Hey, kid. Put your whippy-dink magic screen in front of your TV screen and tap all the hard with your magic wand till they get old fast.
And then be ready to help us with your magic crayon in another exciting adventure of
whippy-dink and you.
Yeah. What? Oh, no! Don't sit down. That's not right.
Oh, Dr. Herman.
Bill was cheap.